The translate CSS function is used to reposition an element to the top, bottom, right, left, front, and back directions. First, we will look at the translate X and translate Y. Then we will also look at the translate Z and translate 3G. The value can be in pixels, inches, centimeters, em, percent, etc. Okay, however, the translate Z doesn't support the value in percentage. Welcome to our CSS lesson. Now, before I begin our lesson, I request all of you to like and share this video so that you would help this video to reach more people who need it. The translate X CSS function moves an element horizontally to the left or right direction. Here we have the translate X 30 pixels. The negative value will shift the element towards the left direction, and the positive value will shift the element towards the right direction. We can write this translate X 30 pixels in other ways too. If we delete this X, it is still translate X, okay? Translate 30 pixels, comma 0 is same as the translate X 30 pixels. These two values stand for X and Y. We can also write the translate X in the translate 3G function, where we can keep the Y and Z silent. The translate Y CSS function moves an element vertically to the bottom or top direction. The negative value will shift the element toward the top direction, and the positive value will shift the element toward the bottom direction. We can write this translate Y in other ways too. Just delete this Y and type here 0 for X and 80 pixels for Y. We can also write the translate Y in the translate 3D function, where we can keep the X and Z silent. We can write the translate X and Y at a time. Here we can see the translate X and Y. We can also write in other ways as shown here. The translate Z CSS function moves an element to the front or back direction in a 3D view. Let's look at this number one, which is the front part of the 3D cube. The negative value will shift the element toward the back direction, and the positive value will shift the element toward the front direction. We can also write this translate Z in the translate 3D function as shown here. Here the translate Z is shifting the element to the front and back directions as we view from the right side, because here the element has rotated by 90 degrees on the Y axis. If we turn off the rotation, we can see here the element is still shifting to the front and back directions as we view the element from the front. The translate 3D CSS function moves an element along the X, Y, and Z axis in a 3D space. It is just like a shorthand method of writing all the translate X, Y, and Z together. Transform is already here, so we can add here the translate 3D function. Let's look at this Z value. The negative value will shift the element backward, and the positive value will shift the element forward. To make this 3D cube move closer or further, we can link here the perspective function with the translate Z. Make sure the perspective function is written before the translate function. Here the negative values will push the object further. The positive values will make the object come closer. As we learned at the beginning, the x value will move the element to the right or left direction, and the y value will move the element to the bottom or top direction. We may also write the translate 3D function in other ways as shown here. That's it. Hope this helps you guys. If you have any questions, do let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Stay technically sound and spread love and compassion to all.